When we think of digital humans, we think of those sci-fi movies where there is a hologram of an AI talking to us, or a 3D human guiding us from our phones. Let's leave it to your imagination, but it's not really far from reality, because we can witness a lot of these in our digital times. From Instagram, we can see an influencer named Little Michaela, and many other CGI from various movies, music videos, and games we see. Today, the modern-day geeks will talk about digital humans and their role in our digital future, so stay tuned and watch till the end. Digital humans, as the name suggests, are 3D representations of humans, whether there's a real thinking person behind them or it's an AI-powered mascot that has the capability to mimic real human behavior in order to form a connection with us. Sounds creepy? Well, it's normal if you spend a lot of time on the internet. The lack of human interaction nowadays paved the way for many tech corporations to develop digital humans that we can connect to. Let's take a look at the digital human named AIKO.
Hello, I am AIKO. Please let me introduce you the latest collaboration between KDDI and Mavari, powered by AWS.
Created with KDDI, a telecom giant in Japan with a partnership of Mavari. AIKO is a virtual assistant that automatically pops up to show and guide you in the direction after you scan your real-life surroundings through the lens of a smartphone. The concept leans more on Metaverse. There are many digital humans across media and entertainment, whether it may be a movie character or a brand ambassador, but the need for these humans across various industries are rising beyond entertainment. These humans are going to revolutionize the storytelling of many films to be made, if that is not already happening. The more we rely on digital connections, the more these humans are going to emerge, and they will be seen on various platforms. They can serve as an AI-powered chatbot that is no days off and may be available for 24-hour customer service. They can also be used by other companies like manufacturing to ensure the safety of their real-life workers by using accurate simulations to know what kind of risks and problems may arise in the workplace. These humans can help the improvement of the creation of synthetic data generation. What is synthetic data generation, you say? Well, as the name suggests, it's a set of data generated programmatically. It's data that is not collected from real-life objects or from experiments. Synthetic data is the key in dealing with privacy issues and reducing bias by ensuring you have the data diversity to represent the real world. Paul Wolborski said, co-founder of one of the first dedicated synthetic data services, AI Reverie. Companies like Synthesis AI, Microsoft, DataGen, Epic Games, and Reallusion are already working on digital human data to train AI models. Whether it may be AI-powered or just a 3D version of us, some may say that we can use these digital humans as our own mascot on the metaverse. It's going to be cool if we were able to have our custom-made 3D avatars of ourselves where we can freely express ourselves without limits. We could have a meaningful interaction with others, especially if these avatars improve that they can accurately represent our emotions and movements to show virtually. There will be many influencers like Little Michaela in the future, but they can't meet fans in the real world. It will probably be forever online. But wait, aren't digital humans hard to make? Many tech companies like Nvidia have been trying to pursue the creation of it for years. In order to make a digital human, we need 3D models, textures, skeleton rigs, and many more. This is where Epic's Unreal Engine, Metahuman, comes in. 3D human creation used to be made in a matter of weeks to months, but Unreal Engine Metahuman Creator can make the highest possible quality of digital humans in the span of minutes to hours. They have been making this program for a long time. Thank you, Epic. The program can also make realistic movements and facial expressions. Epic says that the Metahuman Creator can incorporate motion capture and animation techniques. The execution of it depends on the third-party user, but the standard of the quality of realism is going to always be there depending on the platform. Up until now, one of the most arduous tasks in 3D content creation has been constructing truly convincing digital humans. Even the most experienced artists require significant amounts of time, effort, and equipment for just one character, says Epic's Vice President of Digital Human Technology, Vladimir Mastolovic. In summary, digital humans are going to be crucial for the development of our digital world, not only as a means of our entertainment, but as well as generating and gathering important data for scientific and medical purposes. As we connect more and spend more time digitally, the more these humans are going to be in demand, especially for the metaverse. creepy or cool, digital humans are going to shape our future. Let us know what you think in the comments below. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more modern-day geek content.